This is WYFF News 4 at 11 in high definition.
I drove up from Charleston. Me and my wife have been having a lot of problems.
New details tonight on the investigation into a missing Charleston woman with ties to the upstate. What her husband told a police officer hours before his wife was reported missing.
A church youth director accused of molesting a youth group member. Tonight you're going to hear what the pastor has to say.
And new developments in the case of a local McDonald's employee accused of spitting in a customer's drink. Good evening, everyone. I'm Carol Goldsmith.
And I'm Michael Cogdill. Tonight, police have released some dash cam video of a man suspected in his wife's disappearance. The video shows Bob McCaffrey being pulled over in traveler's arrest on March 18th. Now, this is just hours before he reported his wife missing in the Lowcountry.
Gail McCaffrey was last seen March 17th at the couple's home in Charleston. While her body has not been found and no charges have been filed, Charleston County deputies are calling the case a homicide investigation with Bob McCaffrey as their prime suspect.
News 4's Mandy Gaither is live and local on the story from our Anderson newsroom tonight. And Mandy, this video provides some new clues into Bob McCaffrey's state of mind that night, right?
Well, that's right, Michael. The officer describes McCaffrey as agitated on the tape. He was pulled over in the upstate before reporting his wife missing in Charleston. And after hearing this tape, we know a little more about what was going on that night in McCaffrey's own words.
March 18th on Highway 25 in Traveler's Rest, Officer Patrick Laverly pulled over Bob McCaffrey for going 64 miles per hour in a 45 zone. McCaffrey was on his cell phone when the officer got to his window.
Dude, there's blue lights behind me. Do you want me to take a freaking picture of it?
It's unclear who McCaffrey was talking to, but moments later, the officer can be seen putting a hand on his gun after noticing a 9mm handgun sitting on McCaffrey's armrest.
Do you have a concealed weapons permit?
No, sir.
Has that been sitting there the entire time?
No, here. I just pulled it out. Here, it's buried up underneath
right,
the other stuff.
You got any other weapons in the car?
No, sir.
McCaffrey drove to the upstate after fighting with his wife, Gail, who hasn't been seen since March 17th. Originally, deputies say McCaffrey told them he was visiting family in Easley, but the relatives told News 4 in March he was never there. Back at the traffic stop, the officer asked McCaffrey what was going on, and after a long pause, McCaffrey answered.
I drove up from Charleston. Me and my wife have been having a lot of problems. I've been seeing a girl that lives up here. I came up to see her tonight.
The officer ran the serial number on the gun, and it was registered to McCaffrey and had no hits in NCIC, which is the National Crime Information Center. So the gun was given back to him, along with this ticket. Before driving off, McCaffrey told the officer a little more about the girl he was seeing in the upstate.
I'm just going through a lot of problems. I drove 4 hours to see her, and I got blown off, and
okay.
You know how it is.
More than 15 hours later, McCaffrey's wife and mother of two was reported missing by her husband.
And Gail McCaffrey's family members say she would never have left her children alone. There was a typed goodbye letter supposedly written by her found at the couple's home, but investigators have since said that they believe that letter is bogus. Mandy Gaither, WYFF News 4, live in the Anderson newsroom.
Mandy, we thank you.